This is the new Revopoint Inspire scanner. We're going to give it a whirl and we're going to scan this Sapporo steel hydroformed beer can.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred backpack hanger in stainless steel and aluminum designed by me holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, hold your keys. It's an incredibly versatile tool. You can use it anywhere in your home or office. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel.
Are you an engineer or designer looking for reliable and skilled manufacturers to bring your design to life? MFG.com, the world's largest online manufacturing marketplace, connects you with over 10,000 suppliers across the globe. Browse the directory or submit a request for a quote and receive an average of 4 quotes from U.S. suppliers. Sign up for MFG.com today and take your engineering and design projects to the next level. Visit MFG.com to sign up today. Now, since the Sapporo can is shiny or glossy, we can't just scan it, and we're gonna need to coat it with something to make it matte. And I'm gonna spray and apply some primer. This is an automotive primer to take the shine off the can so that we can scan it correctly and we don't get reflections and errors in our scan. While the primer is curing, let's unbox the Revopoint Inspire. And Revopoint have sent this to me gratis. And I'm opening it up and I'll see what is inside. So I did not pay for this unit, but I am gonna review it and we'll see what it can do.
Okay, standard Revopoint white box with some foam in the top. You got a plate here with some markers on it that you can scan on. You've got a flexible piece of black material that also has markers on it and some sticker markers, a round disc with markers on it, and we've got how to use with some QR codes, which I actually did use to review, the standard little guy to scan, test scan with and practice scan with, a USB connector. This is the USB C to A connector for the turntable. This is the tripod stand. Now let's open up this connector here. It's got an A on one side and a C on the other side, just like this cable does. So it's a step in the right direction, but why we have to include adapters with stuff like this when the world is clearly, even Apple has transitioned to USB-C. Wow, say it ain't so, Sam. Nice that this has a USB-C connector on it. I can now, you know, toss this cable aside and use a standard USB-C cable and just plug it into my computer, reducing some of the cable clutter, but they really need to include that. Now, this, the turntable is nice, also has USB-C, but you can't actually plug it into a USB-C cable and power it. You do need to have a USB-A connector on the other end to power that turntable. A little baffling. All right, when I first get the scanner, I need to calibrate it. You can see I'm using a standard 2 meter USB-C cable, nothing special. It works with my scanner, so that's really nice. Plugged into the front of my computer and into the back of the unit. I twist it around, calibration is complete. I'm gonna be scanning this can on the turntable, so I'm gonna put some lines on the turntable to help me line it up in the middle so I don't get any wobble, to increase my accuracy, hopefully reduce the speed. And in a counterintuitive thing, I'm gonna place objects in front of my object that I'm gonna scan. All right, I am going to scan the bottom of the object first, right? And those dry erase markers that I placed there are basically markers, because this is a cylindrical object, to help me orientate the object correct. And I'm going to scan at the top. I'm going to use the opening of the can to help me orientate that. So just a couple times around, don't overthink it, and I'm off to cleaning up the extra stuff that I scanned on purpose as markers. And this is easily done in the software. I'm gonna mesh this out at the highest quality possible. In the previous Fusion, I used the lowest possible setting, which is 0.2. The combination of these two factors allow me to capture the detail of this can in the scan. It wasn't easy. It took me several tries. I need a little bit of help from Revopoint tech support, but they were able to guide me to create this scan of the can, which I think came out really nice. I'm very pleased that I can see the subtle ribs on the side of the can, and for this scanner, very nice. Let's pull this mesh data, the OBJ file, into Fusion 360. This is my CAD platform of choice. Very nice collaborative software, and see what the scan looks like. All right, looks nice. You can actually see the facets of the can, and this was my goal, or my objective, so to speak. I want to be able to see those subtle details in the can. Now, of course, this is just a mesh object. You would have to rebuild this thing, of course, using the mesh as an underlay, and then rebuild it in CAD to actually get some surfaces. But I feel this data is probably good enough to capture and recreate this can for the subtle details. So I'm pleased. You know, I feel like for the cost of the unit, you get some good results. I'm going to leave a link in the description below. So if you want to get the Revopoint Inspire, just click on the link below and it'll take you to the Revopoint store where you can get one. I want to talk about how this can is made. Now, this is a steel can. It's not aluminum. So it's not draw formed like a regular aluminum beer can. I saw some information on the web that was incorrect about how this was made, and they speculated. And the reason I know this is hydroformed is that at the bottom and the top, the lines don't go all the way to the bottom and the top. So this can is welded along the edge here, and then they coat this can somehow, because it's steel, so it has to be coated to prevent the beer from interacting with it. And then it's hydroformed to get this shape and to put the lines in it. And then they put the cap on it, probably the bottom, and then fill the can and put the cap on the top. That's how they make this can.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.